Hi everyone, welcome to today's class. Oh, sorry about the light, it's sort of fading in and out just there, coming in and coming out. Here I am, a little bit brighter. This class today is an adrenal class centering around the manipura. So I just wanted to talk a little bit about this. So the adrenal glands, they're small organs which produce essential hormones, primarily steroids that enable the body to chemically regulate itself and respond to stress. They each have a unique function, which work both alone and in conjunction with each other. So we have two of them, and they sit directly upon our kidneys. And they're both completely different shapes as well. And the glands are yellowish and weigh just a few ounces, and they're covered by a protective fatty capsule. So excess visceral fat deposited here can cause adrenal stress. And we all understand stress. So how do the adrenal glands function? So the adrenal glands receive messages from the sensory systems of the brain and produce corticosteroid hormones in response. So some hormones respond to signals from the pituitary gland, other affecting digestion, metabolism, macronutrients, and immune response. So the kidney signals production of a second type of hormone, so mineral corticosteroids, so which help control the balance of salt and water in the bloodstream and regulate blood pressure. So a little bit of information about that. So today's class is based on this. And if you put your hands on your back here, your back ribs here, and the adrenal glands are sort of in this area here. So we've all sort of experienced a sore back, or we talk about painful areas of the back. Why is that happening? So maybe sometimes it's to do with the adrenal glands. I've done a small class on this one other time before as well. So just wanted to check back in with this because of everything that's going on in the world. You know, I can't believe I started this online group, when COVID began, and we're still here. We are, 2 years more later, and we're still in this COVID bubble. So anyway, let's get to our mats and practice. I am, as you notice, my boot is off. I still have it, but I've taken it off. I'm walking a little bit on it to give a little bit of exercise, and I still have a compression bandage on this to support my ankle. And I'm not due to go back to the mic cab to get that safety band. So today's class will be mainly seated and lying down on the back. So again, that's another reason why I've been able to sleep, to feel a little bit more comfortable in the practice. I can't cross my ankles so much. Ironically, lying my foot this way, how I twist it this way, feels more comfortable than having it up this way at the moment. So the body is a funny thing. So let's come to a seated position any way you choose, placing a pillow underneath you or a rolled up blanket, and sit comfortably any way you like. Place the hands on the knees, either cupping the knees or palms up. You'll see, close down the eyes. Grow tall in the spine. And start to breathe in long, deep inhalations. As I mentioned in the Lovely Guts group today, you can actually breathe in at least 5 liters of air into the body if you weren't aware of that. So when you breathe in, don't just breathe in through the front of the chest. Take that long, deep inhalation and breathe in, fill up the chest, the side body and the back body. Notice the difference in that when you take that long, deep drinking in 5 liters of air. And releasing and letting it all go. And then relax your breath in between. Drink in that 5 liters of air. And release all breath out, let it come. Make a sound when you send the exhalation out. Soften the eyes as if they're lying in little hugs. Draw the inhalation in long and deep. Maybe raise the arms up towards the sky if you like, reaching and lengthening the spine. Cross at the wrists and exhale, all breath out, let it go. Keep creating like bird-like crossing at the wrists. Let's say crossing at the ankles. Relax the breath. One more of these, drawing the inhalation long and deep. Raising the arms up, breathe that 5 liters of air, feeling that expansiveness in all sides of the body, front, back, sides. Cross with the wrists the other way. And exhale. All breath out, hands down. And send the palms down to the knees and hands up. Fingertips towards the sky. Nice cupping action onto the knees. Check in with how you're feeling today. Set an intention, as always, for being you feel that. Or whatever intention that you would like to receive from your practice into your heart. And exhale it out to the universe. And then let's roll over, removing the pillow, and come onto our backs. Lying down. And just before we lie down, make sure you're mindful and lie down with the head, neck, shoulders broad, chest broad. Spine all in one line. I want you to draw the knees into your chest. Either hold on to the backs of the legs or wrap the hands around. Hold on to the front of the legs, the shins, drawing the knees together. Be mindful that the whole spine is relaxed along the mat. Draw in that 5 liters of breath, breathing in. Feel how that whole back body expands and widens onto the mat. And send that exhalation out long and deep. And a soft core develops in the lumbar area. Draw in the breath long and deep. Expanding the back body and releasing all breath back long and deep. Inhale in once again, drawing the breath in. And releasing all breath out, let go. It's a beautiful class to use just before bed or in the afternoon after a busy day. One more drawing those long deep inhalations in, breathing. Fill up, be mindful of the back body, how it expands onto the mat and lengthens and widens into the whole four quarters. Then relax all breath out, letting go of anything that made today has annoyed you, somebody, or whatever, just let it go. Just breathe it out through the exhalation. Press the tailbone down. And feel the shoulder blades relaxing to the mat. Drawing in light, peace, and comfort. Feeling those breaths up, breathing it in. And releasing with an open mouth, sending your breath out, making a sound when you release, let it go. Roll around on the lumbar area. Rolling, rolling clockwise, feeling that face clock on every point of that lower back. Tailbone down to the 6, rolling around to the 9, the 12, the 3, the 6, the 3, the 12, the 9, the 6. Sending that left foot high towards the sky, drawing the right knee into the chest. Allowing that right knee to fall open a little bit towards the right. Using the inhalation in, exhalation out, point the toes away towards the sky. Feel the length in the leg muscles of the straight leg engaging. And draw both knees into the chest again. Point the toes off the right foot away. Drawing the left knee into the chest. All back bodies on the mat. Allowing the left knee to open out towards the left a little bit. You engage the muscles by pulling the toes off the right foot. Drawing in those long deep inhalations and expanding all four quadrants of the body. Sides, front, back, and draw the knees back into the chest. Pressing the tailbone down. Raise the arms behind you, pointing the toes towards the sky. You have bent knees again. Feeling length from the fingertips all the way broad into the chest. Lengthening of the whole back body. Draw the body up. Using the core. Just releasing the hands to wherever they fall. The shins, to the tops of the knees. And release the hands away again. Draw the hands back up, releasing hands or touching hands to the legs wherever they feel, drawing into the core. And releasing, letting go of fingertips away. Drawing knees into the chest, wrapping the arms around the shins. Or back to the legs. Bring the toes together. And allow the feet to the knees to flop open. Just to find butterfly. In the hands to box the legs, insides of the legs. Suggest the lower back, how you feel. You might need to scoop the head towards the top of the mat a little bit more, lengthen the spine. Allow the legs to drop open towards the sides. Actually, lift my buttocks up down and just allow my back body to rest on the mat a bit more. Feel that expansiveness in the legs, opening, releasing. Drawing in your inhalation in and releasing with the exhalation. And draw the knees back into the chest, wrap the hands around wherever your body allows you. Draw that long, deep inhalation in, breathe it in, those 5 liters of air. And let it all go with an open mouth. Release it, send the breath out, make some noise. Notice if it come out like lines back to the knees. Allow those knees to fall over towards the right side. Right hand there. Wanting a little bit more in this pose, you reach to the outside of the right knee, a right leg or foot, and open up with the leg wide. Or drawing the knees in. Turning and looking over the left shoulder, releasing the left arm out. Relaxing down the shoulders more, left shoulder towards the earth, left ear. Breathing into those side obliques. Drawing in those long deep inhalations in. And letting go with the exhalation. Nothing that you want to hold in your body, any tension, struggles, or stress. Just let it go. Release it out through the exhalation. And slowly, slowly allow the legs to fall to the other side, or if you're reaching your left leg out straight and right leg goes over towards the left, however you want to do, if you want to challenge yourself a little bit more, or just draw the knees in, reaching the right arm out and turning and looking up towards the right. Then press away with that right foot. If you reach that left, right arm out towards the right of that shoulder part. You feel that length in that right side of the body. Pressing away gently, resting that left hand onto the knees if that's where the knees are. Drawing in those breaths, breathe it in, breathe. And let go, breathe it out, make some noise. Never let go of anything if you're quiet or if you really want to release something, you need to make a little noise with the breath. Just completely open it up and let go. One more breath and bring the knees back into the chest. Drink in that 5 liters there, breathe. Feel the heart space up. With so much love and peace for yourself. And if you see darkness and worries and troubles away with the exhalation. And lock the body forward now, or come up however you like into the seated position. Let's finish with some back body stretches, folding over the legs, walk the flesh out of buttocks, send pelvis forward. Wrap Paschimottanasana, toes together. Reach forward with the hands. Feel that expansiveness of the whole back body. Spine is long, grow tall with the inhalation. And with the exhalation, fold the hips over the legs. Stepping at your edge, where you're releasing and opening. Breathe into it. You're finally thinking about drinking in those breaths again and emptying them out fully through an open mouth. Go tall with the inhalation and with the exhalation, release it fully. Take it in fully. And release it out, let it go. One more breath and come up slowly, slowly. Drawing the left knee into the chest. Right leg is pointed away. Wrap that right arm around the left knee. And turn and look over the left shoulder. Right fingertips are far behind, up onto the fingertips. Keep breathing in, growing long and spine. And release out, changing sides. Left leg out. All the right knee in. We're tall in the spine, send that sternum towards the knee. Wrap that left arm around the leg, the knee. Right hand behind, and turn the toes of the shoulder. Point the toes away with the steady. Drawing in the breath, and releasing it out. And unfold out of the foot. Come to a seat position, onto your mats once again. Coming up onto your floor, roll up your feet. Drawing those feet in like Uttanasana or Uttanasana. Like the wings of a butterfly. Feel the pelvis falling forward slightly. Feel the release in the inner legs. Bring the hands out in front of you and raise them up towards the spine. Cross the right arm over the left. And draw the arms into your arms. Go tall in the spine with the exhalation, fold forward. Drawing your hands out in front of you. You may not be able to do that fully, you might be just crossed out like an X shape with the arms, that's perfectly fine. Then release and come back up. And change the spine left over right and wrap your arms into your inner arms, drawing the arms up to the inner openness in your shoulder area. And with the exhalation, go forward. The feeling opening in the shoulders as well as in your legs. Feel soft and at peace. You relax, then hold yourself up, really allow yourself to release and let go. Unfold the arms. Raise the right arm up towards the sky, bend at the elbow, place the left hand on to the right elbow, slowly walk the fingertips down the back. And adjust the legs if you're not feeling comfortable. possibly in the life. Their torn spine, they press down with breath. Drawing in breath, release, and exhaling out. Raise the arms up again and bend at the left elbow. Walk those fingers down the back slowly, slowly. Keep the spine long, head long. Keep drawing in, feeling length. And exhale everything out right there. And release the hands down to the knees. Sit comfortably anywhere you choose. Close down the eyes. Imagine those eyes. In line, you can kind of soft and relax. Feel comfort that you've spent the time checking in with those adrenal glands. Pay attention to them on your back body. Absolutely. Drawing breath in. And releasing breath out. Long deep drinks of liters of air and releasing those liters of air out. Taking your hands to your heart center. May you sleep peacefully. This is the time of your life ending your practice. Or have a beautiful afternoon. Namaste. See you all again. February is best. Come on. Love and light, everyone. Take care of yourselves. Keep eating well, feeding your body as much goodness from the inside that you feed it from the outside with the exercise.